walk 100 miles, I'm gonna whistle all the while, if that's what it takes to make me.
Hey guys, today I am finally teaching you how I get the curls that I wear in nearly every video. They're super soft and perfect left down or to add some texture to an up style. So before we curl, I like to start out with Hairdresser's Invisible Oil. It's from Bumble and Bumble, and it's a serum that just really smooths out and relaxes the hair after blowing it dry. So it'll also add shine and protects against heat. And you'll just want to work it through the mid shaft to the ends and avoid the roots if you can. And you can also use a paddle brush to help distribute the product. And for added protection, I like to use a heat spray as well. This is Hot Stop from Regis, and I love how light it is. I simply just mist it all over from roots to ends, and it just ensures my hair is fully protected. So before we curl, I'm gonna quickly tease the roots. You'll just take a slice of hair near the top of your head and brush the hair towards the scalp. I'm teasing all the hair above my temples, and really this just creates more volume and gives the illusion of thicker, fuller hair. So you'll repeat this on the back and then on the side, and when you're done, you can spray it with your hairspray. So now that our hair is all prepped, let's finally curl. You're gonna need a 1-inch curling wand. If you don't have a wand, go ahead and remove the clamp on a regular curling iron. Section off the top half of your hair with a clip, and then you're going to take a small section from the front and wrap it around the curling wand away from your face. So the last inch or so of hair, don't worry about wrapping around the wand. In my opinion, the curls lay prettier when the ends are straight. In fact, I actually used to straighten the ends, but I'm just too lazy now. So once the hair is nice and warm, release the curl into your hand for a few seconds and then let it drop. So there's a couple different looks that you can get when you're doing this technique. This one that I'm showing you right now will produce bigger waves because we're not actually letting the curl cool. So we're wrapping it around the wand, away from our face, and then releasing the curl, and gravity is gonna loosen up that curl while it's still warm, and it will produce a bigger wave. Once we're finished curling the bottom layer of hair, release another section of the temples and clip the rest up, and then we're just going to repeat and take a small 1 to 2 inch section of hair, wrap it around the wand like I'm doing, away from the face, let it heat up, and then drop it. And so just continue curling until all of your straight pieces have been curled. And there aren't actually many times that I curl my hair without setting the curl, simply because I hate to go through all the effort and apply the heat to my hair to only have the curls or texture last for just one day. So the texture though is really pretty and it's really loose and beachy, so in the end it's all about the look you're going for. But the longer you hold that curl coiled to your head, the bouncier the curl's gonna be and the longer it's gonna last. So in just a minute I'll show you how to set the curls to help them last longer. After you've curled the entire head, go ahead and brush through or finger through the curls. You want the curls to blend nicely and then spray with a texture spray. So you should end up with a soft, loose curl like this. And to get tighter curls, we're simply going to let the curl cool before releasing it. So it's going to create more defined curls like these. And we're basically gonna wrap the hair around the wand away from your face like we were doing earlier, let it get hot, and then coil it up into your palm or wrap it around your fingers like I'm doing here, either way works, and then lay the curl flat against your head and secure it with a duckbill clip. So you can buy these at Sally's or on Amazon, and we're just gonna leave this clip in until the curl has completely cooled. Doing this is gonna set the curl. It's gonna make it more defined, it's gonna be bouncier, and it's gonna last much longer. So if you have really fine hair or hair that resists curl, definitely try setting it. If you don't have duckbill clips, you can use bobby pins, but they usually leave a crease in the curl. So I've found that if you fold toilet paper and place it over the curl before using the bobby pin, it kind of reduces the line. So you can always try that if you need to. Once the hair is cooled, you can go ahead and release the clips. See how bouncy this curl is? It's definitely a lot different than the curls we didn't let cool. So you can either keep all the clips in until you're finished curling all your hair, but I seriously can never find enough clips to do my whole head at once. So once we're finished releasing the bottom half, I'm gonna go ahead and finish curling these top layers. And while I do, I'm gonna kinda quickly go over my hair care routine. So many of you have asked about it. I wash my hair about once a week, maybe twice, and I definitely had to work up to that. But now that I have, my hair just doesn't produce as much oil. So I also work out every day too. Sweat is made up mostly of water, so I just kinda let it dry and style it like normal, and I swear it's not as gross as it sounds. Try it before you judge me. But honestly, day one, I'll wash my hair and I'll leave it down and straight, and then day two is when I'll curl it. And day three, the curls are still intact, just looser, so I'll either leave them down and freshen up just a few pieces, or I'll style it half up. By day four, I'll just throw in some dry shampoo. I use those leftover curls in another half-up style, and by day five and six, I still have texture from the curls, but they're not very pretty anymore. So because I hate to use heat, this is when I'll throw it up in a braid or some type of up style. You can find all the products that I use in the description box, but having the right product definitely helps. So if you have any specific questions, let me know and I'll either make a blog post about it or I'll answer you directly. When we get to our bangs, it's important that you curl the hair further away from your scalp. So I'm starting the curl about 2 or 3 inches down, and this is just going to allow those bangs to swoop nicely, like Ariel. And then you're just gonna finger through the curls or use a paddle brush to separate them. And then you need to get this Redken Wool stuff. It's amazing. It's a gel / spray, and it adds volume and texture. So you'll just simply spray it all over and scrunch it up with your hands, the curls. And it's seriously like magic. I don't know what I ever did without it. I love how much body and volume it adds to my bangs. And the link for this is in the description box, or you can find it on my blog. And if you want to soften up the curls even more, go ahead and take your paddle brush and just brush through the hair. So this isn't going to ruin your curls. It's just going to make them looser, but they'll still last a couple of days. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. There was definitely a ton of information and I tried to pack it all in, but make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any new videos, and we'll see you next week. Bye!
I'm gonna run right up this hill, summer sky or winter chill. Gotta take a break, I will.